study about the topic neuroblastoma. Neuroblastoma is a tumor. Neuroblastoma. It is a malignant tumor. Remember, it is a malignant. Malignant means cancerous. So malignant tumor are the tumors that will spread or metastasis to the distant areas and structures and tissues. So neuroblastoma is a malignant tumor. It is an aggressive tumor of the adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla. So adrenal gland. It is a tumor of the adrenal medulla. It is an aggressive and malignant tumor that will spread to the distant part. As you all know, it is kidney and this is the adrenal gland. So this is the tumor of this part. So this will spread to the kidney, to the pancreas, to the liver, bones, orbit, different structures and parts adjacent to this adrenal. So this will spread along with the sympathetic chain. Sympathetic chain part. Okay. So now we will study the types. There are two types of neuroblastoma. And this neuroblastoma mainly occurs in childhood period up to the age of 5 years. And this is a dangerous or aggressive malignant tumor. And the incidence is both in common in the both sexes, female and male. So the incidence is common in both the sexes. Now this cancerous or malignant tumor occurs mainly in the childhood period up to the age of 5 years. It is of two types. The first is paper type, and the second is Hutchinson's type. So what happens in paper type? It is a right-sided tumor. Right-sided. We all know the kidney lies in both sides, right and left. So the paper type neuroblastoma, it is a tumor of the right-sided adrenal medulla. So what happens here? The secondaries will be in the liver. The secondaries will be in the liver. The metastasis will be in the liver. The second, that is the Hutchinson's type, in this occurs in the left side of the adrenal medulla. This occurs in the left side. And the secondaries are in the bones, like skull especially, and in orbit. Bones and orbit. The secondaries will be in the bones and orbit. So what happened? There will be a ichymosis in the retroorbital region. Now we will move to the clinical features. Sorry, first we will discuss the pathological features, the histopathological condition, then we will discuss the clinical features. So histologically, what we will see, it looks like a grayish red tumor, and the mass will be seen, and when you will see with the eyes grossly, it will seem like there will be necrosis, hemorrhage, and there will be calcification. Also vascularity. So these four features you can see with your eyes: the hemorrhage, necrosis, vascularity, and the calcification formation. Then when you will see with the microscope or histopathologically, you will notice the round uniform cells with hyperchromatic speckled nucleus. So there will be uniform round cells and there will be hyperchromatic speckled nucleus in between the cells. The MSC stain will be positive. MSC stain will be positive. Then also you will notice the stroma. So you can see two types, the stroma positive tumor and the stroma negative tumor. In stroma positive tumor, there is Schwann-Hinn spindle cell stroma, and in stroma negative or stroma poor, stroma poor tumor, there will be no Schwann-Hinn spindle cell stroma. So there are two types, where the stroma is poor and where the stroma is good. So good stroma tumor and poor stroma tumor. The good stroma tumor is that there is Schwann-Hinn spindle cell stroma. Now clinical features. There will be fever, hypertension, anemia, weight loss. Then flushing. Flushing is due to the release of catecholamines. Then there will be diarrhea and low potassium, that is hypokalemia. Why hypokalemia and diarrhea occurs? Due to the release of VIP. VIP is what? Vasoactive intestinal polypeptides, along with the release of hormone ACTH. So the ACTH hormone will get released, and VIP, that is the vasoactive intestinal polypeptide, so this will get released, so there will be hypokalemia, that is the low potassium. Besides this, the major features you will notice: Racon's eye sign. Then opsomyoclonus. Then dancing eye syndrome. We have studied that there are two types. The first neuroblastoma, the first type was paper type, that occurs in the right adrenal. The secondaries are majorly in liver. The second was Hutchinson's type of the neuroblastoma, where the secondaries occurs in the orbit and skull, in the bones area. So the secondaries will occur in the orbit. This is Racon's eye. Here the secondaries will be in the retroorbital region. You will notice the ecchymosis in the orbital region, retroorbital region. There will be ecchymosis. This is Racon's eye sign and dancing eye syndrome and opsomyoclonus. These are the clinical manifestations in case of neuroblastoma. Along with, there will be diarrhea, there will be hypokalemia, that is the low potassium, fever, anemia, weight loss, and hypertension. Then investigations. We will go for the X-ray to look for the calcifications. Then MRI, CT scan, ultrasound. We will recommend this for patient to look for the mass, the abdominal mass. This abdominal mass will be not fixed. It will not move. It will not move with the respiration. You will feel the nodular firmness there. Firmness or a mass you will notice in the abdomen region, that will not move with the process of respiration. It is a non-mobile tumor. So to look for this tumor, we will go for the MRI, CT scan and ultrasound to check the secondaries have happened in the bones and what is the condition. Then we will go for the X-ray. In X-ray, we will notice the calcification of the tumor. Then we'll go for the biopsy. बायोप्सी ऑफ द बोन मैरो. दिस विल रिवील द मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर एंड ऑल्सो विल गो फॉर देयर एमआईबीजी स्कैन. ऑल्सो द एमएसई स्टेन विल बी पॉजिटिव. सो दिस आर ऑल द इन्वेस्टिगेशंस. नाउ ट्रीटमेंट एट एज दिस इज अ वेरी डेंजरस एंड एग्रेसिव मैलिग्नेंट. सो फर्स्ट वी विल गिव द ड्रग एंड द ड्रग्स इंक्लूड डॉक्सोरोबिसिन, कार्बोप्लेटिन, साइक्लोफॉस्फेमाइड. सो बिसाइड दिस ड्रग्स, इफ दिस ड्रग्स डोंट वर्क, देन वी विल गो फॉर द एड्रेनलेक्टोमी. दिस इज द रिमूवल ऑफ द एड्रेनल. सो वी विल रिमूव द एड्रेनल. If the drugs like doxorubicin and cyclophosphamide and carboplatin don't work, then we will remove this adrenal and we will go for the chemotherapy after post-operation, chemotherapy, radiotherapy along with the folic acid supplementation. So neuroblastoma is a very aggressive and malignant tumor of the adrenal medulla. This occurs both in the right and left. If it occurs in the right, this is called paper type, where the secondaries are in the liver. And in the left sided adrenal medulla, that is the left sided neuroblastoma, is called the Hutchinson's type, where the secondaries are in the orbit and in the bones in the skull region. So in clinical manifestations, Racon's eye sign is seen. Beside this, dancing eye syndrome and opsomyoclonus. Other features include diarrhea, then weight loss, anemia, fever and flushing due to the release of catecholamines. Also there is release of VIP, that is the vasoactive intestinal polypeptides, along with the ACTH, that is the hormone. And in investigations, we will go for the MRI and ultrasound to look for the calcification formation in the tumor, to look for the secondaries in the liver, pancreas, kidney. We will go for the ultrasound of the abdomen and we'll go for the MIBG scan. In treatment, we will give the drug therapy, which include the medications like carboplatin and cyclophosphamide. Along with that, if medicines don't work, then we will remove the adrenal, that is the adrenalectomy. After the post-operation, we will go for the radiotherapy, chemotherapy and the folic acid supplementation.